maybe give me a top time in this upcoming, forthcoming election. And I think if I keep quiet, he might throw me out of this seat. I think I know what to do. Yes. Is that the journalist? Yes, this is Chief Martins. Can you come to my office right away? I have some important discussion with you.
My chief.
Let us go straight to the point, because I know you're a very busy man.
Yes, yes, you know, you know.
There is this man, there is a candidate in the forthcoming election, senatorial election, Chief John Nafi.
Chief, why you say another way? Chief John Nafi is doing very well. Everywhere they know him, Chief, the man is even more popular than you.
He's just initial karakara. He's just using media up and down to. He's not working any stronger. I am the chief.
Okay.
So you should know what.
You have been here for a long time. We know now.
And that is the reason I called you here. I've been thinking. I have to give this thing a lot of thought. So I decided to call you. This young man, if I keep quiet, he might throw me out of this seat. So this is the seat that I have been for 15 good years. And I intend to stay here for life. So I want us to cut.
Chief, don't say cut. Chief, I'm not a butcher. I'm a journalist. If you say journalist to cut tail, Chief, it's not contradictory.
Yeah, Ibo Dogun and me.
Abumo Dogun confess.
Sorry, because if me find a corner, you see, you be mad or you see, be yard.
Oh, Chief, Chief, explain for that. Chief, explain for that.
I want us to write a very damaging story about this young man. Yes, I want you to bring incriminating stories like kidnapping and robbery, 419, and anything that can damage his image so that he cannot push forward.
Chief. Chief.
Yes.
Do you have any facts? Do you have any document to prove this affair now?
I am the facts. What does that fact mean? I hope you are not saying that you are engaged in blackmail. Chief, is it not blackmail you're talking about? Whatever thing you call it, please. And I'm ready to reward you handsomely.
Chief, let me even say that, okay, I want to do this job now, Chief. How much will you even pay?
Like I said, I'm ready to reward you handsomely. To cut it short, I'll give you 5 million.
Chief.
5 million naira.
5 million, Chief.
Yes.
Chief, do you mean 5 million?
Naira.
Bam!
You know I'm a man of my word.
Hey, Chief!
Yes.
5 million! Chief, do you mean 5 million?
Yes, 5 million.
Ha!
In short one, I can give you check, I can give you cash, I can even pay before you start.
Hey! Chief, oh, double cable. Chief. 5 million is good, but let me even ask, you know I have a desire to make sure that anything concerning you goes well.
Okay.
And to also make sure to see how you go to cut cost for you so you don't spend too much money.
Man,
you have been there. Chief, do you have any son or daughter that is around?
Of course I have a son and I have a daughter that lives in UK.
In UK?
Why do you ask?
Hey, it's because that man, I don't see the reason why you have to spend five million on somebody like me. Because the truth is that your son or your daughter can actually write this news and post it on their social media handle. And it's for free for you now.
What is there?
What?
Chief?
What are you saying? Chief, are you hungry?
Oh God of mercy.
Chief, are you hungry?
You want my son and my daughter?
Yes, Chief.
To get in trouble with these politicians?
Chief, are you afraid of that?
Of course. Come on. You cannot say that.
You see, this is the reason why journalists should not think of engaging in blackmail. These politicians will use you to do blackmail job and abandon you. This is the kind of job they will not allow their son or their daughter to do.